Hey guys, my name is Jessie Mew, and welcome back to The Sims 4 Create a Pet. Today, I'm going to be making some of the pets that you guys have sent to me, and I have lots and lots of adorable little cats and dogs to make now, lots of them on my list, so thank you guys so much for playing along with me. I hope we're going to have a lot of fun making your little fur babies. I'll try my best to get through as many as I possibly can in all the videos to come, so don't worry if you guys don't see your pet in this video. But today we're going to focus on the dog side of Create a Pet, because I'm sure it comes as no surprise that my main focus has been on the cats so far. So I'm really excited to play around with all of these different dog breeds in here. I mean, look at this list! There are so many dog breeds for us to choose from! And since they're all so diverse, I mean, there's quite a few interesting creatures that we can make. But to start things off, we're going to be making Mr. Furley, who was sent to me by Cinnamon Toast over on Twitter. And is he not just the most adorable little thing you've ever seen? I love his sweet, soft little face. And his name too, I mean, his name is pretty glorious. But it looks like he's a small dog, so we're going to have to try to figure out how to shrink this big guy down. Maybe if we choose a different type of body? No, this seems to just be a changing the body shape. So I guess we're going to have to pick some generic small dog breed to use as a base. It doesn't matter too much which one it is, because we're going to be changing all of those features. Oh, hello! Hello, little one! A cardigan Welsh Corgi. I do love dogs too. I actually have a dog of my own, and I'm not sure if you guys know that. You can probably hear her shaking her head in the background of my videos every now and then. She's a 13-year-old beagle, and she is a sweetheart. So maybe we'll have to try to make her and Create a Pet someday too. But now that we've filled him in with white, it should be much easier for us to try to figure out the features of this dog. And I think we should probably start with the fur. Mr. Furley is very, very fluffy, but he seems to have like a curly texture. Oh my goodness. No, that's the wrong way. We want more fluff. Definitely more fluff than that. Yeah, he has a curly kind of texture to his fur. So something a little bit curlier than this. It almost reminds me of a little sheep. Oh yeah, just like this. This is pretty close. All right, let's go with that and let's try to figure out his face next. Well, those ears definitely need to change. We need something a little bit rounded at the bottom, kind of like these. Yeah, and if we can, maybe make them a bit bigger and bring them out a little bit too. Oh, just like that. Look at those big poofy ears. Can we maybe raise them up a little bit as well? Yeah, looks like that's helping us get the right round shape for his head. We'll have to bring out the rest of his face too to give him a little bit more of a poof on the sides. And then I think we'll want to drag in the snout a little bit as well, because it looks like he has a tiny little muzzle. We'll give him an itty-bitty little smile too, because Mr. Furley looks like he would be a very happy dog. His eyes look super dark, so let's change them over to one of these brown colors. And then maybe change the shape of them too, because they look like they're a little bit rounder. Oh my goodness, those are huge! Look at those giant bug eyes! Maybe we could shrink them down a little bit because I think that's actually a pretty good shape. Yeah, the big round eyes to go with his soft round expression. I think it's coming along pretty well so far. We just have to fix the nose now. His nose definitely looks lighter and a little bit rounder again. He has a super, super round face and I absolutely love him for it. We'll go with this color, I think, and then we'll give him a little bloop of color right on the very tip. Yeah, maybe something like this. Just a little boop right on the tip of his nose. There we go. I think it's starting to come along. It looks like he also has a tiny little stripe above his nose too. So if we can get out of a detail mode, maybe we can try to paint that on. We just need to bring down the color a little bit. Try to make the brush smaller as well. Is this the best view we're going to have of the top of his nose? I mean, maybe if we lay him down, but then that's going to be a super awkward angle, isn't it? Well, at least we can kind of like get the top and start layering in some colors. Then if we sit you back up, we can try to do the rest as well. There we go. I think that's just about as close as we're going to be able to get. Now the last thing we could possibly do is maybe add in some of those darker splotches around his face, just for a little bit of extra detail. I'm not too sure what the rest of his body would look like, of course, so we're just going to really focus on the face. And there we go. I think Mr. Furley is all complete now. So I'll go ahead and change his breed back over to a mixed breed, just for the sake of simplicity, since I'm not sure what breed he actually is, and I don't want to get it wrong for you guys. And likewise, as far as his traits go, if you guys want to see any specific traits on your pets, then just let me know. Otherwise, I will give them the generic good dog traits, because every dog is a good dog, and Mr. Furley looks like a very good boy. So the next dog we're going to create is a German Shepherd named Gannon, who was sent to me by Madison over on Twitter. And I love his big, giant ears. It looks like he'll be pretty easy for us to make because his coat is all one color, but we'll have to make sure that we get those ears just right. So first, we'll have to find the German Shepherd in this list of breeds. They're a pretty big dog. Oh my goodness, look how majestic you look. Absolutely gorgeous. They don't have a black coat, but it should be easy enough for us to just paint straight over in paint mode. If we change it to black, we can fill the whole thing in. And you're already looking pretty close to Gannon. We just have to fix those big giant ears. There we go. That's looking a little bit closer. It looks like we'll need to change the insides of his ears too, because they're definitely not pink. So if we go back into the detail paint mode, then we should be able to fill that all in with that same black fur color. Now, what color are his eyes? They're a little bit tricky to tell from the picture, but I don't think they look brown here. Maybe some kind of like dark blue or a silver. Oh my gosh, all of these eye colors look so pretty on this dog. I think I'm going to go with this color just based on the picture that I have. So I hope that's as accurate as possible. But otherwise, I think Gannon is looking pretty good. So Madison said that his traits would likely be loyal, hairy, and active. So he sounds like he's a very fun little handful to be around. He looks so majestic though. Almost a wolfish with that dark fur, so I'm glad he's joining our little Sims family. Madison also sent me a picture of her little husky puppy, whose name is Rosalina, and she looks like she has a bit of a more intricate coat pattern, so this is going to put my skills to the test. Let's search out the husky first, so we can change her over to the correct breed. Siberian Husky. Oh, I love these dogs. Look at this little guy. He's so cute. I guess we might as well change her over to a puppy too. We can make her as a tiny little puppy. Oh my gosh, that is too much. I guess let's try to get the main coat colors down before I mess up too much here. If we go into one of these options, yeah, this one right here, then we can actually change some of the colors right up on the top. So we don't have to mess around with the markings too much. We just have to figure out what actually changes what. It seems like a lot of this is going to change the colors right over her back, which is good because she seems to have quite a few different browns and grays mixed in. In fact, maybe something like this would be a good place to start. I do want to change those ears though, because it looks like in her picture, her ears are much more floppy, so I think that's kind of throwing me off. The floppy ears on the puppies is just too cute. It looks like we can't make them both floppy though, so we'll just go with this one for now, and then we'll change her eye color to that deeper blue. And now the part that I'm dreading. We have to fix that mask, of course. We have to try to pencil in her markings here. So she has that big long stripe of white right on the top of her forehead. It's definitely going to have to be a little bit thinner than that though. I guess we'll just try to kind of layer this on. So we'll put the main shape on there first and then slowly blend it into the rest of her fur. There we go, I think that looks about right. I tried to add a little bit of texture to the top too with some darker markings. I can't see if she has this white stripe on the back of her head, but it looks like she might not. So we'll have to try to blend that out too. All right, I think that's as good as we're going to be able to get for the markings. So the one last thing I wanted to do was see if we could pull out the snout a little bit, because she seems to have a bit of a more pointy snout on her. They gave this puppy like a big roly-poly soft sort of body, but at least in this picture, Rosalina seems rather slender. There we go, I think that is pretty good. I think this is going to be our lovely little Rosalina. This little puppy's traits are currently adventurous, vocal, and glutton. Look at that giant food dish. A puppy could practically go swimming in that thing. So the last dog we're going to make today was sent to me by Jasna, and her name is Lexi. She described her as being basically like the dog version of my penny cat, which I can definitely see. They do have a quite the striking resemblance with all that fluff. So let's make sure that we get her fur right first, because this one looks a little bit too curly. We want something super long, especially right around like her chest and her face area, which might be a little bit tricky for us to find. Well, I guess this one is the closest. This is probably as close as we're going to get, at least. I would like her ears to be a little bit fluffier, but it'll have to do for now. Oh, wait a second. Maybe we can choose a different style of ear to make them look a little bit fluffier? Yeah, maybe something like this, actually. We'll just have to fit that to her head so they're a little bit smaller. She almost reminds me of a little border collie, maybe? At least in the way that she's shaped. But let's try to paint some of her markings on. It looks like she has some brown right around her muzzle, so we'll layer that one on first so it'll be easier for us to paint the white markings on next. That's going to be the tricky part, I think. It always seems to be the case. Especially because it seems like the top of the snout is one of the hardest places for us to reach. But there we go. I think that's pretty close. And now we can move on to all of that fluff on her belly, which of course is one of my absolute favorite parts. This is where it reminds me of my penny cat too. So we'll fill in her chest with some white first, and then we'll try to kind of like feather it out. We can even use the same wispy little brushes from when we were painting in Penny. Now last but not least, I think we'll need to fill in her toes with a little bit of white. It looks like the very tips of her toes have those white splotches. It's kind of hard to see because they're so small, but if we fill in a couple of these toes, then I think Lexi will be completely finished too. She looks super cute, and I hope I got just the right amount of fluffy for her too. So we'll change her over to a mixed breed. Her traits would be hairy and friendly. And Jasna mentioned that she was very affectionate too, but since that doesn't seem to be in the dog list, we'll go ahead and give her the trait of loyal. She is so cute. So there's a little Lexi. We now have Lexi, Mr. Furley, Gannon, and Rosalina in our tiny little Sims dog family. So I hope you guys enjoyed making these pets with me. I know I'm not a master when it comes to using the Create a Pet tool, but I hope I can get better as I make some more of your pets in the future. But for now, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye, guys!